I just got a call from Adam. My wife is in trouble because Maria is leaving her child every day. Are you not taking care of our child while I'm gone? You're not home right now, are you?
No, she's here, our daughter sleeping next to me.
Huh, then I switched to a video call, showing him our sleeping daughter. The husband immediately started to get confused.
Doug, what's going on?
No, I'm the one who wants to ask. There's no way I'd entrust a newborn to Luna, who I rarely get to see. Finally, the husband seemed to calm down, saying, "You're right, you got an angry phone call from Adam and just contacted me.
My name is Maria. I live in a certain rural area. I graduated from a university in the city and came back home for a job in my hometown. It's said that the wages are low here, and the only decent job is as a civil servant in this countryside, but I like this hometown of mine and I had friends here, so I came back without any hesitation. Fortunately, I also obtained qualifications, so I was able to get a decent job here.
My husband, Henry, is my high school classmate. Unlike me, who went to a university in the city, he attended and graduated from a local national university.
We reunited when we went out drinking together with our friends during the New Year's holiday when we were 22 years old. We got to know each other better, started dating, and after about 2 years, he proposed to me. I love this countryside too, so let's get married and raise our child leisurely if we have one, he said to me, and I was happy. I have friends here, both of our parents are here. I had no worries at all. The only thing that bothered me was Henry's younger sister, Luna. She would become my sister-in-law. Luna has been raised like a princess, and people say she's a bit spoiled. In fact, at the time of the marriage meeting, the introduction of each other's relatives was so long that my husband panicked when she said, "I'm bored, can I use my smartphone?" Despite the fact that we are only 2 years apart in age, and she was already an adult at that time, my husband was desperately apologizing, and he scolded his sister, but she didn't care at all. Even the parents joined in, schooling her, saying, "Oh, you got bored, huh?" My mother was worried, saying, "She seems like a troublesome sister, but we don't live together anyway. They don't get along well as siblings either, so we'll probably only see each other during the Bon Festival or New Year's." I thought I didn't need to worry about it too much, but that was a lightweight of thinking. The wedding was over, and our newlywed life began. At first, everything was peaceful and happy, but little by little, cracks began to appear. My husband's smartphone started receiving messages from his sister every day, asking for money. Most of the time, my sister-in-law dropped out of the beauty school she enrolled in, and apparently, she only works part-time when she feels like it, so most of the time, she lives off allowances from my in-laws and my husband. Needless to say, she lives with my in-laws. I had been getting angry at her for not becoming independent already, but just then, she announced that she's getting married. My in-laws were overjoyed, and I was relieved too, just a little. Now she'll have no problem with money, now she won't have to ask her money from my husband and in-laws anymore. Her husband-to-be, a high school classmate of ours, many friends came to the wedding, making it lively and vibrant. 1 year later, I was blessed with a daughter, and I struggled with parenting for the first time. My parents came to help, but it was mostly one parent's work. My husband helped as soon as he finished work. It was tough, but I believed it was essential for a husband and wife to do it together, so we supported each other and did our best. About 3 weeks after our daughter was born, my husband called during the day. I thought my daughter finally went to bed, and I was just about to rest.
"Hello, is something wrong?"
"It's not just something wrong, huh? Why are you so angry, Henry?"
On the other end of the line, Henry sounded like he was about to yell at me. He must be holding back desperately because he's at work.
"Do you even know why I'm angry? It seems that you leave our child with my sister every day to play."
"What?"
"It was completely unexpected."
Apparently, my husband heard that our daughter has been left with my sister-in-law Luna until he comes home. Luna's husband, Adam, told him, "I just got a call from Adam. My wife is in trouble because Maria is leaving her child every day.
Are you not taking care of our child while I'm gone? You're not home right now, aren't you?"
"No, she's here, our daughter sleeping next to me."
"Huh," then I switched to a video call and showed her sleeping daughter.
My husband started to get confused instantly. Doug, what's going on?
No, I'm the one who wants to ask.
There's no way I'd entrust a newborn to Luna, who I rarely get to see.
Finally, it seemed like my husband cooled down as he said, "You're right."
Adam called him angrily and then contacted me directly.
I am sorry, I misunderstood.
That's not a big deal, but did Adam really say that?
Yay, he was pretty angry too.
He said Luna was on the verge of collapsing.
It seems Adam called out of concern for Luna, probably he's not lying.
If that's the case, then the one lying must be Luna.
Let's talk again after work.
I need to prove to Adam that I'm not leaving our daughter with her.
I'm really sorry, he apologized sincerely, so I decided not to say anything more about it.
But now I'm concerned about Luna and Adam. What were they thinking when they attacked us like that?
At night, after feeding my apologetic husband and putting our daughter to sleep, we sat down to discuss what happened.
To avoid being suspected, let me show you this.
I showed him videos from the baby monitor and the photos I take daily as a record of our parenting. The childcare record, the dates are clearly visible, so there's no room for lies.
After confirming, my husband apologized again.
If you think about it normally, there's no way you will leave our child with Luna.
Luna may have lied to Adam. I wonder what her intentions are.
I'll ask her.
My husband called Adam right away.
Initially, Adam was still angry, but when my husband explained that there was evidence, Adam began to look puzzled.
It's natural since he might be thinking that his wife might be lying. Do you even know what Luna does during the day, huh?
She's a stay-at-home wife, so I assume she's at home.
Maybe that's why you asked her to take care of the baby.
Hey, can you take a day off tomorrow?
I'll take one too, for we tend to go to work but come back home and see what she's up to.
I'll give it a try.
Here's what my husband and I think Luna might be doing, something she doesn't want us to know to cover it up. She might have used me as an alibi.
Adam and my husband took paid leave and prepared for tomorrow.
The next day, both my husband and Adam left the house for work as usual.
Adam came to our house first to confirm the situation around 10 o'clock.
Our daughter was with her grandparents, and my husband, Adam, and I headed to the apartment that Luna and Adam rented.
I hear voices just before opening the door.
We heard voices coming from the small window in the bathroom.
Adam looked anxious, but we already had a hunch.
I'm opening it with determination.
Adam opened the door with a click, and there we saw those are not my men's shoes.
Our hunch was right, there were two people in the bathroom, and they didn't notice her husband.
The three of us headed towards them, there were bags and pants scattered on the way.
We fell silent, but Adam opened the bathroom door energetically.
Yo, no, Luna and Edward.
It turns out all three of them knew each other.
Luna was having an affair with a man named Edward, who was a mutual friend and a high school classmate, and she did it so boldly, calling him to their house.
Why are you here?
I heard from your brother and sister-in-law that you're not taking care of the baby, so I thought you were lying to me.
Why?
I'm not lying. I did take care of the baby.
It was tough.
Why is Edward here then?
Even at this point, Luna continues to stick to her lies.
We decided to take a break from arguing in the bathroom and face each other again in the living room.
Edward, the man Luna's involved with, just kept his head down.
My husband was the first to speak.
First, apologize to my wife.
You used her as an alibi for your affair.
It's not my fault.
No, you're doing something wrong.
You're married, yet you're cheating with another man.
Edward and I are in true love.
I always wanted to marry him, but he has no money, so did you marry me for money?
It was a chaotic situation.
It seemed that Luna and Edward had been involved for a long time.
Edward was a part-time worker hopping from one job to another.
Luna wanted to be a full-time housewife, so she married Adam, who had a stable job.
If she became a full-time housewife, she could meet Edward, have money, and solve her problems.
In reality, Luna used the money for their living expenses to spend time with Edward.
She argued that the money was spent on diapers for my daughter, whom she was taking care of.
That's a pretty clever excuse.
Perhaps that's why she came up with the lie that she was forcefully taking care of my daughter.
I don't want to talk anymore, Adam.
You should involve a lawyer and discuss compensation or think whether you'll get divorced.
What compensation?
As sorry, I can't afford that.
I have a fiancé.
What?
What a man. As it turns out, Luna wasn't Edward's first choice. Luna was left speechless.
No, I'll make sure to claim it properly, and I might even report it to the authorities.
Please spare me from that.
Who are you asking to spare you?
Both my husband and I were angry at being used, but Luna just kept crying like a tragic heroine.
Was I being played even though I loved you so much, Adam? Was the only one after all?
I'm sorry.
I apologize.
So let's go back.
Maybe that's what they call being naive.
She believes that if she asks for something, it will be granted.
Well, the truth is, my in-laws have been fulfilling her wishes all this time.
Adam decided firmly there is no way we can go back.
What you talk about true love, but do you think you can come back to me just like that?
It's strange, you're weird.
Luna and my mom and dad say that I'm cute, so everything I ask for will be given.
Everyone will believe me.
Stop saying childish things.
What a pitiful Luna.
To be honest, what did Adam see in her?
Well, there are still people who like the naive type. Let the landlord know that we'll be moving out next month.
You should pack your things too.
Also, a lawyer will be in touch.
Same for Edward.
No, no way.
Say I annoyed, Adam left the house with his belongings.
Days probably know he's escaping divorce.
At this point, there's no way they'll get back together after all that has happened. They both hope to have nothing to do with each other anymore.
However, this time, my in-laws came to visit.
Somehow, after hearing the situation, my mother decided to barge into the house.
So you two are trying to tear Luna and Edward apart, huh?
That's not true, Mom.
Yes, my in-laws knew about Luna and Edward's relationship.
They knew it even before the marriage.
It seems my mother-in-law had concerns about Edward, so she encouraged Luna to marry Adam with the same thought process.
She supported the affair, saying that as long as their daughter is happy, it's okay.
So that's why Luna mentioned during the discussion that everyone believed in her and brought up the in-laws.
I can't believe it, to go this far just because your daughter is cute, if it's for Luna's happiness, nothing.
No, apologize and pay the compensation as Adam requested.
It's your fault.
I felt disgusted hearing that.
It's one thing to do it for their daughter, but to go this far, it seemed my husband felt the same way.
He clenched his fist and trembled.
Mom, you're always like this. Luna was always a priority, and I was always second, but it's because you were strong. Luna was always so weak.
What's weak about someone who's cheating?
You guys should be the ones apologizing to Adam's parents.
Right, how can you talk back to your parents like that?
Luna did nothing wrong.
It's their fault.
Since talking wouldn't get us anywhere, we just kick the mother and lie out.
If we left it like that, she might stay until I hate her.
The compensation. Luna herself kept sending messages to my husband's phone, demanding compensation every day, so my husband decided one thing.
Cut ties.
Even though they were family, I tolerated whatever happened at the wedding, but now that they involved our daughter and me, any hesitation disappeared.
My husband quickly changed his phone, blocking all contact from his sister-in-law and mother-in-law.
They came to the house and shouted, "Where's the compensation?
What about our cake giving?"
But there's no way we'd comply with that.
After that, Luna was immediately asked by Adam for alimony of 3 million yen.
Edward was asked for $2 million.
Neither of them had any savings, so they both went crying to their respective parents.
Unfortunately, even the in-laws had no money, they had always relied on my husband to pay the compensation.
My father-in-law suggested selling the house, which led to a big argument.
There's still life after this, you know. Maybe selling it would be better financially.
Edward's affair was exposed to his fiancée, and she also demanded compensation.
It was just before their engagement, apparently.
On top of that, Luna was asked for additional compensation.
Edward was cut off from his family since they were classmates. News of the affair spread among their local friends, and everyone distanced themselves from them.
To make matters worse, the fiancé's father was a wealthy businessman in the town, and he quickly put pressure on various companies and stores.
Edward, Luna, and my in-laws were shunned in the community. They can hardly even work properly, let alone shop at that supermarket or store in that extremely rural area.
Why did it have to turn out like this?
I didn't do anything wrong, Luna kept saying until the moment the house was sold.
But it seems the in-laws finally woke up or had a realization that their parenting was flawed.
You're the one who cheated, daughter.
How you are. Mom, you were supporting me. It's too late now.
Go. The in-laws' house quickly became vacant, and they moved to the neighboring town with little money.
Well, it's even more rural, otherwise, they couldn't afford the rent.
Now they live in a remote area with no convenience stores or supermarkets, unable to waste money, so they're living a frugal life.
Luna is crying every day and doesn't work.
That's because her life is far from ideal. Furthermore, this made my in-laws angry, so they're constantly arguing with each other. It's too late to change their personalities now, they are both responsible for this, and Luna's spoiled behavior is partly the parents' fault.
They should have taken responsibility and stayed with her. Edward couldn't bear being ostracized and moved somewhere else.
I heard my husband received a letter saying, "Please send us money."
Are you just turning a blind eye to the hardship your parents are going through? If you're my brother, help your sister. Luna is so beautiful.
Well, he didn't bother responding, but out of beauty, he sent them 3 kilos of rice.
That's enough for them to consider it a complete break.
As for Adam, he received the compensation and seems to be doing okay with everyone's encouragement. Adam was a serious kid, that's why he believed Luna's lies.
It seems Adam occasionally goes out for drinks with my husband and gives him updates. As for me, it looks like I'm expecting a child next year.
Because of this incident, I informed my parents, and now they're telling me to stay at my parents' home for a while after the second child is born.
Looking back, my mother's worries were right. I won't have anything to do with my family anymore. Don't worry and focus on giving birth, my husband's words are reassuring.
Although we got caught up in a strange situation, it will probably become a funny story someday. For now, I'm just thinking about my husband and the child in my belly. Don't forget to hit that like button if you enjoyed this video, and if you're curious to see where this journey takes us next, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you won't miss a single update. Your support is what keeps this channel alive and kicking, and every like, comment, and share means the world to us. We've got plenty more stories, insights, and surprises coming your way, so stay tuned for the next video.
Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.